First step in this 1984 VX1000 compression test is simply connecting the battery to make sure that I can get the starter to turn the engine over. I've already gone ahead and disconnected the spark plugs from the coils so that I can't get any ignition inside the cylinders. You'll notice that I'm actually using a battery charger to make sure that the battery isn't drained due to excess turning of the engine. I don't want to waste the brand new battery. Here I'm removing the spark plug from the rear cylinder so I can insert my compression test gauge. There is a way to boost the compression to make sure, because this is a cold compression test, by putting some oil in the cylinder. You don't want to do too much because it'll get stuck down in there and burn out once you finally start the bike. Now that the spark plug's removed, I'm going to insert the compression gauge into the rear cylinder so that I can actually turn the engine and test the compression. These wires jumpstart the engine. As you can see, the gauge needle has increased to about 150 psi, which means relatively good compression in the rear cylinder. I'll retest this just to make sure that everything's the way it should be. Actually was able to get a higher compression on the second attempt, which means that on a cold engine there's going to be some variance. Not a big deal. Now time to move on to cylinder in the front of the bike. I'm going to go ahead and remove the compression gauge and reinsert the spark plug just to ensure proper operation. It's probably better to leave the spark plugs out, but they are just barely threaded in. I didn't want to get any dirt in them while I was doing this. Don't you mind people grinning in your face? Now I'm going to repeat the same process on the front cylinder to make sure everything's operating within specification. A true friend is hard to find, so don't you mind people grinning in your face?